and I grew up in San Francisco together, and as I was saying a little bit before the movie started, we sort of had, long before we ever thought about making a movie, we would share these stories with each other. Out of our group of friends, we were probably unusual in the sense that we felt like we could be vulnerable with each other and share things that we wouldn't share with other guy friends of ours.
Naturally, being San Franciscan, we're kind of, it's a very, it's built on nostalgia kind of, because, you know, there's a lot of old architecture, rich history, like, you know, in the 60s there was all this music and all these artists that were kind of coming there, and, you know, that used to be what it was known for, like artists could afford to live there, which they can't anymore.
I think gentrification can feel like this term that we think of in regards to statistics, and the way that, you know, many of us from San Francisco experience it doesn't feel statistical. It feels like these more amorphous things that are hard to describe, you know, certain smells, characters that are staples of your neighborhood who one day aren't there anymore, who used to be on the stoops, different shops that like defines your childhood that you went to every day after school on your way home.
Feels like I'm doing one of those Vogue tutorial videos. And my hair looks really yellow in this type. So I've made it to Holland. I'm here for the first time in over a year, which is great. I really missed it. Growing up, I used to go 4, sometimes even 5 times a year. So it's good to be back. I'm staying at my auntie's house for a few days and then going to Amsterdam on Thursday. For the weekend, which will be great. I always love it there. Staying in an Airbnb for the first time. Looking forward to exploring some new areas I haven't been to before. I need to do a bit more planning. I've been finding some good brunch spots. Because food is a priority, right? Also looked at different cinemas, like independent cinemas or like cinema kind of spaces. There's one place that's running an independent film festival. Free, which is really cool. I'm always kind of looking into that wherever I go at the moment. And yeah, spending a lot of time with family, catching up with some family friends, and I probably look exhausted. I shouldn't be, I've just been sitting down in a car all day, but you know, I get tired easily. It's like a get unready with me video. I feel like that would be too boring. So yeah, I'm gonna get ready. My makeup vibe, and I'll see you tomorrow.
We'll be right back.
Tuesday. I've had a lovely relaxing bath. I probably haven't had a bath in about a year. Longer. Makes it sound like I haven't washed in a year. I have, trust me. So that was nice, read my book in the bath. Quickly, before we go out to meet a relative for a drink, I thought I'd show you what I got yesterday. So I just bought the one thing from Costes. Nicely packaged. I got this t-shirt. The colour doesn't seem to be showing up very well in this light, but it's a navy blue with what looks more to me like orange, but it's coming out quite yellow on camera. See, normally I'm not a big fan of French words like randomly stuck on t-shirts, but I just really love this colour combination. So I'll probably be wearing this at some point this week. Something I can see myself wearing with quite a lot, with blazers, just on its own when it's warmer. I don't buy clothes too often, so I try and think more carefully about what I'm buying.
Oh, really, they're cold out there.
Oh, I'm wearing a jumper.
Well, you'll be right.
So I just got ready and actually have some work to do. Every month I write very short film reviews for the program that my cinema releases. Yeah, unfortunately the deadline for this month is when I'm on holiday. I did some of the work before I went away, so hopefully it shouldn't take too long. I've got about 50 minutes before I have to go out. And then I'll probably finish it tonight because I'm going to Amsterdam tomorrow, so. The films I'm reviewing are The Farewell and Judy. The Farewell was a really emotional film for me. Although it's very specific to a certain culture and the director's story, there were parts of it that I found really moving and that I could relate to. It's about a Chinese-American girl who lives in New York and her grandma is ill, terminally ill, but the family don't want to tell the grandma and they try and keep it a secret and they orchestrate this wedding between one of the cousins and his girlfriend so that they all have a reason to be there. Would highly recommend it. Well, I grew up with a grandmother in a different country and that process of being apart and the visiting and yeah, I don't know. There's a lot in there that I found really beautiful. So I'm working from this table and the wood is really beautiful. I love the blue and the different colours in the table. Also gorgeous chairs. It's kind of suede brown. I feel like I'm doing a bit of a house tour now. I won't show you most of it for my family's privacy, of course, but my auntie's great at decorating. She has these little seasonal pumpkins at the moment because it's autumn and October. There's another one here. It's a bit dark in here, but there's also this beautiful display of the Girl with a Pearl Earring painting. Yeah, can't really get any more Dutch than this, right? I'm procrastinating, as is often the way when I have a deadline. So, yeah, I better get writing. I was only falling in love. I was only falling in love. I've sent my reviews off now, and I'm gonna repack my stuff for Amsterdam tomorrow. I have a cold. Sorry if I've sounded kind of bunged up this week. But yeah, I think this is where I'll end this vlog, and I'll do a separate video for Amsterdam. It's meant to rain most of the time, so it might be a rainy one. Probably gonna have to be indoors a lot. eating appelgebak and bitterballen and all the good Dutch stuff. Yeah, we'll see. So yeah, this has been a bit of a snapshot of my time in Holland, in the area that, well, I say I grew up in. I've never properly lived here, but I've grown up visiting and spending a lot of time here, so basically where my family's from. So yeah, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.